You're listening to the BarDynasty.com podcast. Now, live from the MVP Sports Studio in Laughlin, Nevada, here's the GOAT of the sports betting industry, Chris Barr.
Well, I'm back with another podcast here. September 3rd, about to be September 4th here. It's Tuesday night. This won't be on Fox Sports Radio. A matter of fact, fuck Fox Sports Radio. They don't want to pay me. I'm not going to take the time and do a show for them. I'm already a big name in the industry. I'm not worried about it. I got enough clients. I got enough people listening to me. I don't give a fuck. I want money. What the fuck is going on here? I want money. If you're going to put me on the radio and I'm going to be giving out my solid picks. You guys listened to the podcast last week. I literally gave out so many fucking free winners. A ton. I gave out the suspect parlay. I just can't believe that one. I'm going to give you guys another suspect parlay tonight here on the podcast. I'm going to give you guys some more free plays in college football, some more NFL. I'm giving away the Thursday night NFL pick. I'm giving it away for free. If you want to get on my service from Friday to Monday, because I'm giving it out for free, Thursday is going to be free to all the clients. I'm doing $200. So pretty much $200 for the weekend. You'll get Friday night. You'll get Saturday, all day Saturday, morning, afternoon, night, play of the week. My play of the week doesn't lose. So you'll make your money back if you just bet the $200 on my play of the week or whatever. Most people that gamble with me bet, you know, at least $500 to $1,000 a game. So you're making good money when you're playing with me. The play of the week will win. And then also Sunday, NFL, I will have an NFL play of the week. Morning, afternoon, Sunday night. Monday night football has two games. So for $200 Friday to Monday, you're going to get some solid plays. You're going to get some solid play on Saturday, Sunday, and you'll get a play of the night on Monday. There's two games. I'll probably have picks on both games. So you're getting a good deal of $200. And this is for brand new clients only. My existing clients, if you're listening, we made a deal already for the week. Some of them get discounted. Some of them don't get discounted. Some of them are working percentage. Some of them are not working percentage. This week only, college football, week two, NFL, week one. You can get both sports Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. New client only special, $300, PayPal, Venmo, Cash App, Zelle, Bitcoin, MoneyGram, Western Union. Get a hold of me, picksbyemail@gmail.com. Last week I killed it. Last season I killed it. There's nobody in this industry that wins more games. Get a hold of me, picksbyemail@gmail.com, or you can text 702-475-7080. Text only, 702-475-7080. Listen, do not pay people that don't know what they're doing. If they're coming at you and they're charging $100 for a month of service, it's because they're worth $100 a month for the service. The reason I charge $300 is because I do this day in and day out, 24/7, 365 days a year, and I win more games than fucking anybody in this industry. Get a hold of me if you want to make money. Serious people only. 702-475-7080. This week only, college football, week two, NFL, week one. You can get both sports Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. New client only special, $300, PayPal, Venmo, Cash App, Zelle, Bitcoin, MoneyGram, Western Union. Get a hold of me, picksbyemail@gmail.com. Last week I killed it. Last season I killed it. There's nobody in this industry that wins more games. Get a hold of me, picksbyemail@gmail.com, or you can text 702-475-7080. Text only, 702-475-7080. Listen, do not pay people that don't know what they're doing. If they're coming at you and they're charging $100 for a month of service, it's because they're worth $100 a month for the service. The reason I charge $300 is because I do this day in and day out, 24/7, 365 days a year, and I win more games than fucking anybody in this industry. Get a hold of me if you want to make money. Serious people only. 702-475-7080. All right, so let's talk some NFL football for this weekend. First things first, I'm going to mention, if you want this pick on Thursday night, Green Bay Packers at Chicago Bears, this is one of my big plays for the week. If you want this play absolutely free, email picksbyemail@gmail.com, picksbyemail@gmail.com. That's the only way you're going to get it for free. It's a client play, and it's a winner. So let me just go over this game real quick, though. Everybody knows the Packers have owned the Chicago Bears over the years. Aaron Rodgers has owned the Chicago Bears. Looking back right now, the last 19 matchups, the Green Bay Packers have won 16-3. Let's look back at their last game that they played against each other at Chicago. Can Chicago beat them again for two times in a row? They won 24-17 last year on December 16th. All right, and then as you know, Green Bay came back. I think it was week one last year. The Packers were at home. Aaron Rodgers went out, came back, came all the way back and beat them, as he always does to the Bears. But the Bears got him in Chicago late in the season. And then will they get him again on Thursday night? Like I said, if you want that pick, the only way to get it is to email picksbyemail@gmail.com. No questions asked. You'll get the pick 100%. I want to see if I can get 300 people to email picksbyemail@gmail.com. That's the goal, 300. How many of you guys want to win on Thursday night? There is nobody in this industry that wins more fucking games than me. There's nobody in this industry that's more cocky than me. And I'm cocky because I win games. All right, moving forward here. Packers and Bears, 24-23, beginning of the season last year. Before that, in Chicago, the Green Bay Packers beat them in 2017, 23-16. Year before that, Packers beat them in Chicago, 30-27. A year before that, Bears lost again, 31-23 at home against the Green Bay Packers. The year before that, Packers win 38-17 at Chicago. Year before that, Packers win 33-28 at Chicago. Year before that, Packers win 21-13 at Chicago. Year before that, Packers win 27-17 at Chicago. Year before that, Bears 21-14, the Packers win at Chicago. Year before that, and this is the last win in 2010, Packers lose 20-17. So the last two times they've played, or the last two times they've won in Chicago, 20-17, and then last year 24-17. So you're looking at an average right there, the last two times that they've won. If you're thinking Chicago's going to win, you're looking at like a 24-21 kind of game, 21-17. Kind of game if you think the Bears are going to win. Now, the Packers have blown them out several times, 16-3 their last 19. This game's pretty much, I'm not going to say a toss-up. I know exactly who's going to win this game. None of these stats mean shit, honestly. What matters is Thursday night, what's going to happen on Thursday night. I'm not going to sit here and say I got inside information. I'm talking to the coaches, the referees. Anybody that says they're talking to the players and all that shit, full of shit. That's totally illegal, by the way, if you actually try and talk to the players or the coaches or the owners of the team. Nobody's talking to no owners and coaches, okay? There's guys that bet $1 million a game that don't even talk to the players or anything like that. Floyd Mayweather can throw $5 million on a game, and he never talked to any of the players or the coach. He might talk to the players, but he ain't talking to them about the game or the results of the game. These players can't really – the referees are more to put the game if it was a fix. The referees are the ones you need to talk to. And I don't think Floyd Mayweather's walking around talking to NFL referees. But he does have a lot of power. You never know. But I doubt he's going to be involved in something like that. So If you want this play, picksbyemail@gmail.com, and you'll get it for free. First NFL game of the season. Clients might be pissed off at me because, you know, I'm giving out this pick for everybody to, you know, to grab a hold to. But it's a strong play, and this pick will win. So we're going to move on to Sunday here in a second. Let's take a break, and we'll get back into the NFL card. This week only, college football, week two, NFL, week one. You can get both sports Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. New client only special, $300, PayPal, Venmo, Cash App, Zelle, Bitcoin, MoneyGram, Western Union. Get a hold of me, picksbyemail@gmail.com. Last week I killed it. Last season, I killed it. There's nobody in this industry that wins more games. Get a hold of me, picksbyemail@gmail.com, or you can text 702-475-7080. Text only, 702-475-7080. Listen, do not pay people that don't know what they're doing. If they're coming at you and they're charging $100 for a month of service, it's because they're worth $100 a month for the service. The reason I charge $300 is because I do this day in and day out, 24/7, 365 days a year, and I win more games than fucking anybody in this industry. Get a hold of me if you want to make money. Serious people only. 702-475-7080. All right, so let's get into college football and NFL. If you guys listened to the podcast last week, you'll know that I destroyed it. Unbelievable record. Clients, play of the week, Auburn, just everything. I gave out suspect parlay. I gave out I gave out four predictions on games, and I was like right on the money on all of them. There's seriously nobody else that predicts and gives out more free winners than me in this industry. There's a lot of guys that do podcasts every day or every week that don't have a clue. They really don't. They don't know what they're talking about. They're reading trends. They don't know what they're doing. It's pathetic. There's so many people out there that do this and that don't have a clue, and they don't even know that they don't have a clue. William & Mary at Virginia on Friday. Virginia minus 35, over under 44.5. If you're going to take Virginia minus 35, might as well take the over. Virginia and over. William & Mary, are they going to score in that game? Wake Forest at Rice. Wake Forest minus 19 on the road. Over under 58.5. Rice hung in there with Army last week. Wake Forest should have their way with them. I think they cover the 19. Marshall at Boise State. Boise State minus 12. Over under 57. I'm going to give out a podcast free play parlay. Nope, not a parlay. Teaser, excuse me. We're going to go Boise State minus 2. That's the first leg. Boise State minus 2. That's on Friday night. So if you're looking to bet this weekend and you want a good teaser for Friday and Saturday, get on Boise State minus 2 for the first leg. Sacramento State at Arizona State. Arizona State minus 36, over under 63. A lot of points expected in this game. Arizona State will probably give up at least 20. Will they cover the 36? I'm not too sure. I don't trust this team. I'd never trust Arizona State. Ohio at Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh minus 5.5, over under 54. This game's early Saturday morning. That Arizona State game's on Friday night, by the way. So this is the first Saturday morning game, 8 a.m. Las Vegas time. Pittsburgh minus 5.5, over under 54. This is a suspect. This is going to be on the suspect parlay. Why is Pittsburgh only minus 5.5? I understand Ohio's decent, but Pittsburgh should win that game. They're at home. Suspect parlay number one right there, Pittsburgh money line. We'll see who we can parlay them with. Old Dominion at VT. Virginia Tech minus 28, over under 56. I can see Virginia Tech putting up some points. Possibly an over 56 in that one. We'll move on here. West Virginia at Missouri. Missouri minus 14, over under 62.5. Possibly a lot of points scored in that one. We're going to skip that one. Charleston Southern at South Carolina. No line. Vanderbilt at Purdue. Purdue minus 7, over under 55.5. Purdue should get the job done in that one. Maybe put them on a 7-point teaser. Get them down to pick them. Bowling Green at Kansas State. Kansas State minus 24, over under 58.5. I have nothing on that one. Kansas State should demolish Bowling Green. Rutgers at Iowa. Iowa minus 20, over under 49. Last week I said I liked Iowa and they covered the 21. Barely. It was a close game in the first half. Rutgers played pretty decent. They won. They played against the junk team, but they go on the road here at Iowa. Iowa's going to be tough. That defense is tough. Rutgers is going to have trouble scoring, I believe. I would probably lean Iowa minus the 20 in that one. Syracuse at Maryland. Maryland minus 1, over under 58. We're going to skip that one. Army at Michigan. Michigan minus 22, over under 47. As you guys know, Fat Man on Campus is on Army. So most likely the play in this one would be Michigan minus 22. If you want to get them down to minus 20 or 20.5, go for it, just in case they win by 21. But the way that guy picks games, Michigan might win by 49. 42 to 49. They might blow the shit out of Army. That guy does not know what he's doing. UAB at Akron. UAB last week minus 42. They only win by like 6. UAB minus 9 on the road here at Akron. 46.5 over under. It just makes me laugh because I just remembered Fat Man on Campus gave out UAB minus 42 last week and they only won by 6. That's like giving out TCU minus 55 last week, and TCU didn't even score 30, I don't think. I don't even know what the final on that was. It was like 10-0 at halftime or something. Kennesaw State at Kent State. Nothing on that one. Southern at Memphis. Nothing. Cincinnati at Ohio State. Ohio State minus 16, over under 54. Ohio State should have their way with Cincinnati. They should cover the 16. I can see this game be... I can see Ohio State scoring in the 50s, honestly. This is not a game I'm getting involved with this weekend. But if you want to make some money, I think we'll go Ohio State podcast free play. Because it's not going to be a client play, but they should cover 16. There's too many other good games on the board for that one. Western Carolina at NC State, nothing. Northern Illinois at Utah. Utah minus 21, over under 43. I can see this game going way under 43. This is a good defensive battle. Under 43 is probably going to happen in that one. I can see like a 20-3, 17-10, 17-6, something like that. South Florida at Georgia Tech. We're going to go podcast free play under 43 on that one. South Florida at Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech minus 6.5, over under 62. I'm going to put this on the suspect parlay because Georgia Tech should be giving up at least 10, 13 points in this game. South Florida is not very good at all. We're going to go suspect parlay, Georgia Tech, money line. So you got two of them there, Pittsburgh and Georgia Tech at home. They should beat South Florida. I don't see why they shouldn't. Central Michigan at Wisconsin. Wisconsin minus 35, over under 51. Wisconsin win 49-0 the first game. They're back at home now. 5 touchdowns against Central Michigan. Yeah, they should cover 35. Nebraska at Colorado. Colorado plus 4, over under 65. We're going to put Colorado on the 10-point teaser, get them up to plus 14. I think it's going to be a close game. I have Nebraska winning this game. But I have it being close. This is a close one. It's a good one too. It's going to be a good game to watch. Colorado money line possibly. If you're trying to back Colorado in this one. Here's the thing. I like Colorado in this game, but my stats say Nebraska's the play. This one's confusing to me, so that's why I'm giving it out for free. Colorado plus 14, with Boise State minus 2. And it's not going to be a client. I'm deciding it's not going to be a client play. It is going to be a podcast free play teaser. So there you go. Charlotte at App State. App State minus 22, over under 54. App State, very good team. They should get the job done. They should cover 21, 22 points in that one. Richmond at BC, no line. Southern Miss at Mississippi State. Mississippi State minus 17, over under 51.5. I really don't care about any team from Mississippi. Texas A&M at Clemson. Clemson minus 17, over under 64. I will have a client play in that game. Get a hold of me. Illinois at Connecticut. Illinois minus 21 on the road, over under 59. Illinois should destroy UConn. They should destroy UConn. Texas, San Antonio at Baylor. Baylor minus 25, over under 57.5. Why is Baylor only minus 25? That's weird. Not going to even touch that game. Murray State at Georgia, nothing. New Mexico State at Alabama. Alabama minus 56, over under 64.5. I should give out New Mexico State plus 66 because I don't think Alabama's, if they get to 63, I think it's done. I don't think they're going to get to 66 or 70. New Mexico State plus 10. If I was to do a 10-point teaser on that game, I would definitely take New Mexico State and get them up to plus 66 points. If Alabama wins 70-0, I'll be surprised, but I don't think they will. I can see that game. I could see 52-3. I think New Mexico State puts up a field goal. I don't think Alabama will cover that game. I don't think they'll cover 56. If they do, they do. But I think 66 is a very smart move getting them up. San Diego State at UCLA. UCLA minus 7.5, over under 45.5. Another possible 7-point teaser here for UCLA. Get them down to minus 0.5. I should put this on the suspect parlay. UCLA should have no problem beating San Diego State. San Diego State is a joke. So, yeah, that's the third team. We'll go for the suspect parlay. We'll go three-team suspect parlay. Pittsburgh money line. Georgia Tech money line. And UCLA money line. Next game, Northern Colorado at Washington State. Washington State, no line. They should be minus 50. They'll probably cover it. UL Monroe at Florida State. Florida State minus 21, over under 63. I really have nothing to say about Florida State. Jump on the ball. When there's two guys around the ball, fall on the ball. You fucking losers. You cost me. They literally cost me $7,600. I had a big parlay that I would have won. It was $1,000 to win $4,500. And then I had another couple thousand on them. Fuck that team. Fuck that. And I'm not talking 70, you know, I'm talking that's how much I would have won. That's not how much I, you know, I put up. I put up a lot. Would have cashed out for over 10 on that game. But the pieces of shit lost to Boise State. I don't even think they scored in the second half. That's a piece of trash. 31-13 and they lose. Who does that? Piece of shit team. Let's go North Texas at SMU. SMU minus 3, over under 72.5. You can see a lot of points in that one. 72.5, maybe the over. Western Kentucky at Florida International. Florida International minus 7.5, over under 56. I got nothing in that one. Central Florida at Florida Atlantic. Here's the third team. I think Central Florida on paper is the better team here. I don't think they're going to lose to Florida Atlantic. We'll go the 10-point teaser. That'll be the third. That'll be the third one. Boise State minus 2. What was it? Who was it? Plus 14. Colorado plus 14. And Central Florida, pick 'em. There you go. There's a teaser for you. Free one. Coastal Carolina at Kansas. Kansas minus 7.5, over under 54.5. Here's another one to add to the suspect parlay. I had Kansas last week on the suspect parlay, and they got the job done. So do a four-teamer. You guys know the teams. I'm going to bet it this weekend for $100 because these teams should be winning these games. Coastal Carolina on the road. Come on. Come on, Les Miles. BYU at Tennessee. Tennessee minus 3.5, over under 52.5. Tennessee lost outright last week. BYU played like shit. They're a shit team. This game's a coin flip. So, get a hold of me. I'll have a play on that game. South Dakota at Oregon. South Dakota at Oklahoma. No line. Oklahoma probably destroy them. I'd say the line's probably 41. I don't know. McNeese State at Oklahoma State. No line. Oklahoma State possibly minus 45. Western Michigan at Michigan State. Michigan State minus 16, over under 46.5. Yeah, Michigan State never covers. I stay away from them. Tulane at Auburn. Auburn minus 17.5, over under 51.5. Auburn should win that game. I don't really have nothing on that one. Tennessee Martin at Florida, nothing. Eastern Michigan at Kentucky. Kentucky minus 15, over under 53.5. They should beat Eastern Michigan, right? LSU at Texas. This is the game of the week right here. Everybody's going to be watching this one. It's 6.5 right now. Texas plus 6.5. Could go up to 7. Over under 55.5, get a hold of me. You want to win that game. I know who's going to win that game. Arkansas at Mississippi. Mississippi minus 6.5, over under 50.5. I stay away from shit teams like this. I have nothing to say. Like I said, I don't like any teams from Mississippi. I don't bet on any of them. Nevada at Oregon. Oregon minus 24, over under 61.5. Oregon should destroy Nevada. I can see Oregon putting up 45 to 55 points in this one. Maybe like a 49-17 game or something. They should cover easily. Oregon minus 24, podcast free play. Buffalo at Penn State. Penn State minus 29, over under 56. Buffalo was minus 49 last week. They didn't cover. I said I wouldn't put my money on Buffalo minus 49. Penn State last week, minus 45. They did cover, 79-0. They play each other now. Four touchdowns and a field goal for Penn State. I think they'll let up a little bit this week. They'll still win the game. I'm not sure they'll cover 30. Stony Brook at Utah State, nothing. Liberty at UL Lafayette, nothing. Prairie View A&M at Houston, nothing. Miami at North Carolina. The line was 6. Now it's down to 3.5. Miami minus 3.5. It's probably going to go to 3. 47.5. A lot of people on Mac Brown this week. I'm going to have a play on this game. Get a hold of me. UTEP at Texas Tech. Texas Tech minus 34.5. Over under 65. I think Texas Tech destroys them. Straight up. I think they destroy them. We'll go Texas Tech minus 34.5. Podcast free play. Tulsa at San Jose State. Tulsa minus 7 on the road. Over under 52.5. Nothing. Arkansas State at UNLV. UNLV minus 1. Over under 63. Nothing. California at Washington. Washington minus 14. Over under 44.5. Get a hold of me. Minnesota at Fresno State. Minnesota on the road minus 3. Over under 48.5. Get a hold of me. Stanford at USC. Stanford plus 1 on the road. The quarterback is out for the season, by the way. Out for the season. So this is a game right here that I don't understand the line. I think Stanford wins the game. Podcast free play, client play. Stanford plus 1. I might put him on a teaser, get him up to plus 11 for Stanford. So I'm just going to go podcast free play Stanford money line to win the game. I'm not trusting USC without a quarterback. Come on. That guy from Arizona that came in last week wasn't anything special. Oregon State at Hawaii. Hawaii minus 6.5, over under 78. Hawaii should win this game. Put them on the suspect parlay. That's 5-teamer. And then you got Northern Arizona at Arizona. And I know the line to this. It says no line, but I know the line. It's 26. Arizona coming off a loss against Hawaii, having a couple weeks off, going to be pissed off. They always beat the shit out of Northern Arizona. Northern Arizona is in Flagstaff, Arizona, not very far from Prescott, where I grew up. So I know a lot about Northern Arizona. I know when they go on the road, especially against a team like Arizona, a pissed off team in Arizona, I don't think they have a shot in hell. I would say minus 26, Arizona, podcast free play. Now, if you guys play all my podcast free plays and some of them lose and you don't profit, don't get pissed off at me. These are just free plays. If you want my client plays, you just got to get a hold of me. picksbyemail@gmail.com. And remember, I'm giving out the Thursday night football game absolutely free to everybody that texts or emails. picksbyemail@gmail.com. And remember, on your cell phones, if you go to text, you don't have to text the number. You can text the email. Just go from the numbers to the letters and text in picksbyemail@gmail.com from your phone, and it'll go right through to the email, and we'll get right back to you with the play. And we got to move on to the NFL. This week only, college football, week 2, NFL, week 1. You can get both sports Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. New client only special, $300, PayPal, Venmo, Cash App, Zelle, Bitcoin, MoneyGram, Western Union. Get a hold of me, picksbyemail@gmail.com. Last week I killed it. Last season I killed it. There's nobody in this industry that wins more games. Get a hold of me, picksbyemail@gmail.com, or you can text 702-475-7080. Text only, 702-475-7080. Listen, do not pay people that don't know what they're doing. If they're coming at you and they're charging $100 for a month of service, it's because they're worth $100 a month for the service. The reason I charge $300 is because I do this day in and day out, 24/7, 365 days a year, and I win more games than fucking anybody in this industry. Get a hold of me if you want to make money. Serious people only. 702-475-7080. All right, so I'm going to get rid of the NFL, and it's not going to be a very long NFL deal here because I have a lot of client plays in the NFL. You want the Thursday night, you got to get a hold of me. You know that. Rams at Panthers. We're going to go Rams money line podcast free play, podcast client play, Rams money line on the road. That's the only one I'm going to give you guys right there. Take the Rams. They're going to beat the Panthers. And that's not even my best play, not even top five, to be honest with you. You want to get a hold of me, get a hold of my top five, you just got to pay the price. Washington at Philadelphia, Philadelphia minus 10, over under 45. Here's the three-team 10-point teaser I'm going to give you in the NFL. Eagles pick them. Get them down to a pick 'em. Seahawks are minus 10 against the Bengals. Get them down to a pick 'em. And then my third team that I want to give you is going to be, we'll go, I haven't thought about this. What can I give you? Just throwing it out there real quick. We'll go Raiders plus 10 at home on Monday night. So we'll do Raiders plus 10 with the two teams that are minus 10, the Eagles and the Seahawks. And I'm not promising you that either one of those two teams win. I'm not on any of these three games, honestly. It's going to be a podcast free play. There you go. It should win. I'll probably throw a little bit of money on it, but it's not a very, you know, it's not my client play. Sunday night football, I want to mention Pittsburgh at New England. New England minus 6, over under 49.5. I have a huge play on that game. Monday night football, the Seahawks play the Texans, or the Saints play the Texans. Saints are minus 7, over under 53. I have a huge play on that one. Let's see. Lions at Cardinals. Lions minus 2.5. Over under 46. 46.5. I have nothing on that one I can't talk about. Giants at Cowboys. Cowboys minus 7. Over under 45. San Francisco at Tampa Bay. Tampa Bay, it's a pick 'em. Get a hold of me, you guys. There's so many great plays this weekend in the NFL. Colts at Chargers. Chargers minus 6.5. Over under 44.5. No Andrew Luck. Somebody tell that goofball that wears the sunglasses indoors that Andrew Luck retired because he's a fucking clown. He doesn't know what he's talking about. He doesn't pay attention to anything, obviously. He doesn't know nothing about sports. The Chiefs play at Jacksonville. Tennessee plays at Cleveland. Baltimore and Miami. You guys know the whole rundown of the card. Atlanta at Minnesota. Buffalo at the Jets. You just got to get a hold of me. Get a hold of me, picksbyemail@gmail.com. I appreciate every single one of you that's listening. Hit the subscribe, hit the like, share on Twitter, share on Facebook. Get a hold of me. Have a good one.